¿Qué pasa? ¿Sa pase? In this edition of Crime Time News, we see that the major organized task force has launched an investigation for over an year, and they basically busted 63 gang members. We are speaking from the Wandan gang, which are some affiliates or break off or defectors from the Klansman gang. So now people, we are speaking about Spanish Town. We are speaking about the likes of Tesha Miller. He was or is alleged one of the leaders of that gang. So anyways, according to the report and based on what the top cop we are speaking about, Mr. Bailey, is saying, they launched this investigation for over a year. And they basically have 33 of the 63 people in custody, including the leader of the gang, and his name is Andre Brown, aka Gapman. They say that these people are wanted for murder, they are wanted for extortion, they are wanted for shooting with intent, they are wanted for illegal possession of firearm, they are wanted for all sorts of things, Rete and Lele. So they say that they are wanted for all sorts of crime and criminality and all sorts of illegal activity. So definitely with what is going on in Jamaica with all the murders and the shooting and Rete and Lele, we see that this is happy redundant. So therefore we see that now we have 33 people in custody. And the next 30 is on the run. So remember, we are speaking about 62 to 63 people. And based on what the top cop is saying, they have enough evidence because they have launched this investigation for over a year. And they are almost guaranteeing that these people will be convicted, tried, convicted, and sent to prison for a very long time. And people, the truth and the fact is that we should hope for the best and expect the worst, because we always hear the confidence of the police and law enforcement and the prosecutors and Rete and Lele whenever they arrest these gang members. And the truth and the fact is that when it goes to court, it is a different result. So basically it is contradicting or conflicting what they say. And we've seen this with the latest high profile case that is now in the court. We are speaking as it pertains to the Uchens gang, because we see that at least 20 something of them were arrested. And at least as the case went on, we see that at least 6 have been let go because there is no charges, because there is no witness on Rete and Lele. So like me say, we have to just hope for the best and expect the worst. So the moral of the story is that based on the history of the Jamaica court system, we can expect a lot of these people we are speaking about out of the 63, we can expect at least a quarter of them to be let back on the street to continue their business as usual. Now, according to the deputy commissioner we are speaking about, Fitz Bailey, he said that 24 of these men will be taken to court today and another 9 will be on an identification parade. It is said that these men are responsible for over $57 million worth of extortion. So basically they are being charged for racketeering, being a part of a criminal organization, conspiracy and extortion. So people, we see that these are very serious crimes. So therefore we see that we can expect them to get the fullest extent of the law. And it is also said that they are responsible for over 30 murders. Now people, we are speaking about a lot of life that are gone too soon, RIP. So just based on the seriousness of the charges, we can almost expect them to get decades in prison, point blank and period, and that is deservedly so. So people, like I've always said, we see the efforts of the police and we have to also applaud it, even though we see that the results are not there like we expect. So anyways people, that is my views and opinion as it pertains to this investigation, as it pertains to these 63 gang members. We are speaking about the Wandan gangsters from Spanish Town. And people, like me say, it is just my views and opinion, it is not the gospel. Your views and opinion can be respectfully different from mine, but let me know what you think in the comment section. So the next thing that is popping in the news, we see that the police has put out an alert for some suspected or alleged abductors. And they made reference to 2 different incidents in the St. Andrew area. We are speaking about the first one, that is at a supermarket. And this is based on the account of the boyfriend of a lady that was watched by these alleged abductors. Now, according to the story, or according to the boyfriend, he said that his girlfriend went to the supermarket, and while she was at the supermarket, she realized that some men were watching her or looking at her in some suspicious way, in some strange sort of way. So basically, after she saw that, she kind of panicked, she kind of got scared, and she called her boyfriend. And when he came to the supermarket, she basically, they were kind of whispering, and she basically told him and kind of pointed out the people. And he said he saw the same thing when he was at the supermarket. He said these people were kind of acting suspicious. And he also said after they finished their shopping and went outside and saw the men, they were acting bummy. They were acting suspicious. They were acting like some thief. They were acting like they were up to no good. So now people like me say, sometimes we see things and based on what is going on in Jamaica, people can get panicked, them can kind of get paranoid. So therefore, it is a figment of their imagination. But sometimes things are so obvious. And also based on the history of so many women and Pitney and all sorts of people getting taken away and found in the worst case scenario, we can understand why people are going to be paranoid or suspicious. But sometimes when things is obvious, it is obvious. So this story was also collaborated by some other joggers in Barbican. Now people, there is a special place that a lot of people that is uptown in the Barbican. We are speaking about one of the top of the top residential neighborhoods in Jamaica. We are speaking about expensive houses and Rete and Lele. So anyways, these ladies were jogging and they said that they saw some men approaching in a Probox motor car. So them kind of get bummy because, you know, them kind of fit and them kind of jog and a run and kind of pay attention. And when they noticed that the men were actually attacking them and them basically take for themselves, jump some fence, run over two bushes and Rete and Lele and kind of got away from the abductors. So now people, based on what is going on in Jamaica and based on the incident at the supermarket and based on these two women also seeing the same thing, we see that it is verified, we see that it is validated, that something is definitely wrong, that there are some men out there that are out to abduct women. And people, when we think about this, we have to think about the situation as it pertains to the supermarket. Because if they are watching somebody in the supermarket, it seems that they were basically going to drive behind that person and follow them wherever they were going. And then next thing you know, this lady got missing. She got robbed or she even got raped and end up in the worst case scenario, end up in some bushes, stiff stone cold. So now when we go back to the Barbican incident, we see that these ladies kind of take away themselves. And based on the fact that this place is a very rich place, them have them King Alarm and them have them Brinks Alarm and Rete and Lele. So people were alerted and then the man them have to kind of take away themselves, them kind of blaze out of the neighborhood. So people, the moral of the story and the motive of the story is that for you women in Jamaica especially, please be careful, be mindful, and know that you are out there, you are being targeted by these evil men. So when we think about what is going on in Jamaica, we see that these young men, we see that these men, they have lost their morals, they have lost their scruples, because first time, old lady, woman, pregnant woman, and Pitney, they were not on the list. They kind of got immunity. So basically what I am saying is that now we see that things have changed for the worse, point blank and period. So anyway people, that is my views on the whole situation as it pertains to that. And like I said, it is just my views and opinion. It is not the gospel. Your views and opinion can be respectfully different from mine. But let me know what you think in the comment section. Now the next thing that is popping in the news and something that I should have addressed maybe about a day or two ago. We saw that a young lady was stabbed. We are speaking about a lady whose name is Jolene Brown. And she was allegedly stabbed by her baby father. We are speaking about the father of the child that she bore. And this lady is said to be from Porus in Manchester. Now people, when we think about things like these, and we think about a man and a woman in a relationship, and we are speaking about love, and the fact that they even have a child or brought a child into this world together. And now we see one gone and the next one is on the run from the law. And what makes it even worse, it is said or it is alleged that he also take himself with the Pitney. So therefore we see him take the woman's life and him gone with the Pitney. Now we are speaking about somebody that is reckless. We are speaking about somebody that is evil. Somebody that just committed a wicked and dangerous act. And now he's in possession of a child. Now people, what can you expect? What does the future hold for a child like this? Because him lose his mother and now him father are go to prison. So the moral of the story is that it is a strong possibility or probability that the father is going to prison for a very long time. More than likely for life. So now, people, what are the odds of this little child coming up to be successful? So now we see once again the domino effect and the ripple effect that it is going to have on our next child in Jamaica. So my point is that the expectations are going to be very low for this child. We are speaking about the possibility or probability that this child is going to be emotionally stressed, emotionally distressed, emotionally scarred, point blank and period. So anyway, people, that is my views on the whole situation. And like I said before, it is just my views and opinion. It is not the gospel. Your views and opinion can be respectfully different from mine. But let me know what you think in the comment section. Bless up.